This gathering brings together nearly 1,000 participants from more than 65 countries, representing all areas of agriculture, nutrition and health.
Malnutrition is not only a consequence of poverty, it is also a cause of poverty.
There is no more basic need than the food man eats.
Nutrition is the natural bridge, let me say, between agriculture and health.
If we don't actually look at the broader forces at work, we will not achieve the desired improvements in reducing hunger.
We have, I think, a poor understanding of what we want to ask the agricultural sector from the health point of view or from the nutrition point of view.
We need to answer these questions. Are we growing the right foods? Are we growing them in the most efficient way with respect to inputs, water and land? Are we growing them in the most sustainable way?
It's not enough for us to just increase the quantity of food available to the world's most vulnerable. We must also improve the quality of their diets by ensuring they have access to diverse and nutritious foods.
How do we get people to demand tasty foods that they can afford and that are accessible? I think we'll continue to be unsuccessful in some of the new challenges. I think you need an enabling policy environment, but I think we have to collectively do more than that.
In other words, a cross-disciplinary solution to a cross-disciplinary problem, not a siloed solution. It needs health specialists, educationists, social scientists, agronomists, on and on and on.
Universities train tomorrow's development professionals. We can and should begin now to incorporate elements of agriculture, nutrition, and health training into that education.
If we could really actually plan programs and projects so that we explicitly include nutrition objectives right from the beginning when these projects are being designed, then that's the way we will get impact.
Research efforts have made it possible to biofortify some crops for better nutrition outcomes.
Business has tremendous and mostly untapped potential to contribute to improving food security, agriculture, nutrition, and also health.
And to start improving the food conditions of rural communities is only fitting if done with participatory manner and well attention to socio-cultural issues of local communities.
There's an enormous, enormous amount of effort that needs to be made in better data systems, household level data, panel data, district level data, etc.
What we need actually are some really good impact evaluations which show that if you invest in nutrition, you also get better nutrition and health outcomes.
But we need champions who have got passion. People who actually have a passion to make a difference.
Firstly, making sense of the links and incorporating those links into our work. Secondly, getting the right policies. Third, engaging stakeholders and getting them to work in transformative ways. Fourthly, focusing on action and measuring results. And fifth, communicating and telling the story.
We need to invest in agriculture and in the complementary types of investments in other sectors that will bring about improvements in nutrition.
In order to grow more, you have to give incentive to farmers to go into production.
So partnerships, communication, and a mutual accountability can create incentives for working together.
A crisis of this magnitude will be solved only through an intensive global effort that brings together governments, the private sector, NGOs, scientists, and citizens.
The synergy between agriculture, health, and nutrition is, in my view, a missing link in many of the cases where, in spite of numerous government efforts, we are not able to achieve the targets because those linkages which are necessary are missing.
We have a tremendous momentum, and by we, I'm talking about the community under the leadership of IFPRI and a number of development organizations who are into this as well. We must not lose this momentum, and that means that while we are doing research, filling knowledge gaps, improving the data, we must also promote action.